When you hear the expression, "it looks like a herd of elephants came through here," you probably don't visualize a healthy and prosperous forest with a lot of upright trees. After all, elephants are huge and stampy, and it's somewhat easy to think of them as destroyers rather than caretakers. But some populations of elephants are adapted to forest life, and not only do those forests generally remain standing, but those elephants and their picky taste buds are doing a favor for not just the forest, but the entire planet. The reason? Is carbon sequestration. Carbon sequestration is one of the best tools we have for fighting climate change, and the term can mean a couple of different things. Often it refers to machines used to remove carbon dioxide from the air. This is a technology engineers have been trying to develop, though it is still in its infancy. But there's also natural carbon sequestration. That's when ecosystems remove carbon from the air through natural processes. Soil stores a lot of carbon. In fact, a lot of what's in soil is carbon from decayed plant matter, microorganisms, and other sources. And forests are also pretty good at sequestering carbon, what with all the tree growing incorporating carbon dioxide into wood and other plant matter. You might picture elephants reversing that process to some extent, what with all the stomping. After all, even though forest elephants are adapted to living in forests, they are under no evolutionary obligation to help the forest lock up carbon. But they do lock up carbon! A 2023 study in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences looked specifically at African forest elephants, which are not the same as the elephants you've probably seen thundering around the savanna in National Geographic. Savanna elephants eat an eclectic diet of grass, bark, leaves, fruit, and foliage. Basically, whatever they can find out there. African forest elephants, on the other hand, mostly eat leaves. And like humans, they prefer leaves that taste good. Typically, the leaves they eat are less fibrous than the ones they avoid, and they don't contain unpleasant chemicals like tannins. Now, some humans love tannins because they make wine dry and distinctively bitter, but other animals don't really appreciate them in the same way. And that's because tannins are a defensive chemical. We're not supposed to like them, and elephants avoid them because they're smarter than you. The more palatable leaves that elephants prefer come from trees that have low wood density. These trees aren't very good at storing carbon. The wood is less dense, so there's literally less carbon in it by volume. Which means the elephants are toppling, eating, and ultimately thinning the trees that are less efficient at carbon capture, and leaving those that are more efficient. But there's more! Forest elephants also like to snack on fruit. The fruit they prefer grows on different trees, ones that have higher wood density. And when elephants eat fruit from those trees, it helps to spread their seeds around, which ultimately increases the number of dense wood trees in the forest. And that helps increase carbon storage in a second way. It's a subtle balance, and we can't really slap a number on how much climate change elephants might be stopping just by living their lives. But the authors suggest the effect on high wood density trees alone could mean that a forest without any elephants might store up to 9% less carbon in its trees. Elephants also aren't the only large herbivores that can have this kind of impact on carbon stocks. The presence of any kind of large wild herbivore seems to contribute positively to soil carbon, not just in forests, but also in grasslands. But megaherbivores are not as abundant as they used to be. During the late Pleistocene, there were at least 50 different species worldwide. And while all those Pleistocene megaherbivores ate a lot of plants, they also helped spread seeds around, cycle nutrients, and make ecosystems less susceptible to fire. And it seems likely they contributed to carbon storage too, in much the same way elephants do. Today, there are only a handful of megaherbivores left, including three kinds of elephants: hippos, rhinos, giraffes, and bovines like bison. Carbon storage might be a kind of selfish reason to protect them, but honestly, I'll take any reason they give us. For more on elephants, we also have a SciShow video on the secret language of elephants, which is very good, and I think that you should watch it.